Different installation, and as before, we need to work out the earthing arrangement. This one has its origin, so we're going to go and find the meter in position this time. It isn't outside, there is no meter covered this time, so we're going to have to go and investigate where the meter is and the consumer unit and see if we can work out which earthing arrangement we have this time. So this time we're under the stairs with the mains intake position, okay, and we're going to look and see which earthing arrangement we have this time. Could be the same as our last video. Our last video we identified a TNCS earthing arrangement. We're going to have a look and see what we've got this time. So as before, we've got a kilowatt hour meter. We've got our cutout section here, including our cutout fuse, which this time is rated at 60 amps. Remember, it can either be rated at 60, 80 or 100 amps for a single phase domestic dwelling. We've got our tails for our consumer unit here, as before, are sized at 25 millimeters squared, and our earthing conductor is sized at 16 millimeters squared. Please note, in this installation, the supply authority's side of the meter, the tails are 16 millimeters squared and not 25 millimeters squared. This installation, unlike the previous one we looked at for the TNCS earthing arrangement, has no double pole switch inserted in the tails. So in these tails here, we cannot isolate the consumer unit itself. Isolation for the distribution board has to occur within the distribution board itself. So in the event of you requiring to change the distribution board, you would need to pull out, the, in this case, the 60 amp fuse, which is sealed by the supply authorities, and you would require permission before breaking those seals. So to work out the earthing arrangement we have this time, we'll look at the supply authority's cable incoming into the bottom of the cutout, which is here. We can see it's considerably larger in size, physical size that is, than the one we had on our previous earthing arrangement. And we can quickly identify here this braided section off the sheath of the incoming supply cable, then terminates into our MET, our main earthing terminal, and goes off in the 16 mil earthing conductor to our consumer's unit. So we've got a slightly different arrangement here. We haven't got it coming out of our cutout as we did on our TNCS earthing arrangement, where the earthing conductor and neutral were together within the cutout. We've actually got it separated off the sheath of the incoming supply cable. We see the connection from the sheath of the incoming supply cable has been labelled with safety electrical connection do not remove. If this was to be disconnected from the installation, the whole installation would lose its incoming earth. So we got to look at the supply authority's cable incoming to work out the earthing arrangement we've got. We can see this time we have this steel outer sheath being taken from the outside of the supply authority's cable into the MET, the main earthing terminal, and not in our previous earthing arrangement TNCS, coming out the same termination point as the neutral. So therefore this earthing arrangement must be different than the one we previously looked at in our video. So we're now looking at a earthing arrangement where it comes off the outer sheath of the supply authority's cable. So we're looking at a TN, a terra neutral, and then S for separate. In other words, the supply authorities will bring in a line conductor, a neutral conductor, and a separate earthing conductor into the installation. The two common materials used for this separate earthing conductor coming into the installation are either lead of the sheath of the cable or steel of the sheath of the cable. In this instance, we're coming off with a connection to a steel sheath cable. If it was a lead sheath cable, care must be taken to check the clamp around the lead is correct. Sometimes they try and use bonding clamps, which works really like holding putty or Play-Doh. The more you squeeze it, the more the lead will move away and be less tight. You normally have to sweat on to a lead sheath cable in order to connect your earthing conductor. So to recap then, the supply authorities have brought in a cable containing three conductors. Line and neutral conductors terminated within our cutout, separated for a neutral, and the line going through, in this case, the 60 amp incoming fuse. We're using the outside sheath of the cable to provide us with our earth connection. Okay, so it goes into our MET and then goes out into our 16 mil earthing conductor. The incoming supply authority's cable often have lead or steel sheath for that protective conductor. In this case, we're connected to one which is made of steel. We will see later on in our learning at college that the TNS, the terra neutral, the earth and neutral, a separate TNS earthing arrangement, has a maximum external earth fault loop impedance of 0.8 ohms.